Dear students, the next one is define multiplexer. What is data selector? Define multiplexer. Multiplexer is a type of data selector which will select one of the input from many input and move it to the output. That is called as a multiplexer. Multiplexers are used in telephone circuits, in data transmissions, etc. So what is data processing circuits? Data processing circuits are nothing but which process the data. The example multiplexer, demultiplexer, decoder, encoder, all these are the data processing circuit. What is the difference between demultiplexer and demultiplexer? Multiplexer is the circuit which moves one of the input from input to the output depending on the control signal. So demultiplexer is the one where one input is moved to the many output depending on the control signal. That is called the difference between multiplexer and demultiplexer. So now, what is the difference between demultiplexer and decoder? Demultiplexer and decoder, difference is demultiplexer has got data and control lines. Decoder has got only control lines and output lines. So based on the control lines, output signal will be selected. In demultiplexer, data will be moved to the output line based on control signal. So let me explain you here. So suppose if I take this one, let me explain. So this is 8:1 multiplexer. That means there are 8 input lines are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You call this is D0 to D7. D7 and output is 1 based on the combination of the control signal. These are called as control signal A, B, C. If A, B, C 0, 0, 0, that time when it is 0, 0, 0, that time D0 is selected and D0 is moved to the output. 0, 0, 1, D1 is moved to the output. That is this one. Then demultiplexer is 1 to many. 1 to many based on the control signal. Based on the control signal, this input is moved to the particular output. And decoder is, there is no input. What we do? We will take the demultiplexer and we will ground it. This is demux. Demux and we will ground it. And depending on the control signal, output signals are selected. So that is called as a decoder. So this is 8:1. So here, how many control lines required? This is based on the formula 2^m. For example, for 8:1, what is the m? M is equal to 2^3. That is 8:1. For 16:1, 2^4. M is equal to 4. That control signal is 4. That is 16 input, 4 control signals required. 32 input, 5 control signals are required. So that is the difference between multiplexer and demultiplexer. What is encoder? Encoder is a device which encodes the information which is used in data transmissions. When transmitting data from one end to the other end, normally data are encoded and it's sent. So what are the application of parity generator and checker? Parity is nothing but it indicates number of ones in the signal. So it is widely used to determine the errors when the information is transmitted from one end to the other end. In parity generator, what parity generator will do? The parity generator will generate either 1 or 0 based on the number of ones in the data stream, and that will be added to the data and sent to the other end. On the other end, checker will check the number of ones. If it is not matching, that means there is a error in the signal. There is an error in the transmission. That is called as a parity generator. What is strobe signal? Strobe signal is used in multiplexer. It is an active low signal. Without that signal, IC cannot be enabled. Like if you are using 74151, it is a 8:1 multiplexer. Their 7th pin is a strobe. That pin you have to ground it. It is active low signal, you have to ground it. Then it will enable the IC. What is the difference between PAL and PAL? What is the difference between PAL and PLA? Sorry, this is PLA. One is programmable array logic, other one is a programmable logic array. What is the difference between this and this one? PAL and PLA. So now, programmable array logic, input is fusible, that means input is programmable, output is fixed. Either output is fixed or array, and input is programmable AND array. In the case of PLA, programmable logic array, input and both output are fusible. That means both input and output are programmable. So this is used to implement our Boolean expression. So this is used to implement our Boolean expression. This is the difference between, please remember, this is the difference between PAL and PLA. PLA, both input and output are fusible. So input is AND array, output is OR array. Both are fusible, means both are programmable. But in case of PAL, input is fusible, output is fixed. So that is the difference between input and output. So next one is, what is a code converter? A code converter will convert the particular code into different code. That is called as a code converter. So we have different types of code converter we have implemented in the lab. First one is the gray code converter, binary to gray code converter. Then accessory code. What do you mean by accessory code? Accessory code is the one where we add additional 0011 to the existing code. For example, you take any decimal number. For example, you take the decimal number 4 and you express this in binary 0100. For this, you add 11. Then the existing code is called as accessory code. That is called as accessory code. What is gray code? Gray code is a non-weighted code. It is used in most of the application. So, gray code is a non-weighted code. There is no weight for that one. For example, if you take binary code 1100, it is binary code. It has got a weight, positional weight, that is 8421. This bit has positional weight 8, this bit has positional weight 4, this bit has 0, this bit has 1. But it is a non-weighted code and it is used in many applications. How to convert binary to gray code? For example, if you will take 1101, how to convert this? This is the binary, how to convert this in gray? First write this one as it is, then add this and this, 1 and 1, 0. And this and this, 1 and 0, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So this is our gray. Now how to convert gray into binary? So write down 1, write down MSB as it is, then add this one to 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, ignore carry. Then 0, 1, 1, this is our binary. So that is the difference between gray and binary. Then to design 32:1 MUX using 8:1 MUX, how many control lines are required? Normally to design 32:1 MUX, you have to use the formula 2^m into 32. So 5 control lines are required to design 32:1 multiplexer. Then what is ALU? ALU is nothing but arithmetic and logic unit. Arithmetic and logic unit. It contains, it will do the job of arithmetic and logical operation, and it will also as a control unit. And what is a processor? Microprocessor is a device which has got ALU and control unit and other instruction. Along with other instruction, it will work. That is called as a processor. What is a full adder? Full adder will add 3 bit and it will generate output carry and sum. Half adder will add 2 bits and it will generate carry and sum. That is the difference between a full adder and a half adder